shoes. Finishing touches on it, which include some lettering. I have taken a really long time to finish these compared to, I guess it's taken a long time to do the finishing details compared to the rest of the shoe, and I think that's because things are left up to me and my choice, creative choice. It takes me a long time because I tend to overthink things a lot. It's terrible. Sorry, that's a fan. It's just gonna be filming, so this is just on my stand for I have a stand for my light, and it's kind of a little bit wobbly, so if you don't like the wobbliness, sorry. Noise, click off. But it's not too bad. It's a freeze day. Paint pens, and I love to use them, but when I do, if you notice, this right here is the paint pen. It really doesn't give a good coat of paint, and it tends to crack. So I like to go in with the outline of my paint markers, and then I fill in with regular acrylic paint with a fabric medium, and then once I do that, I will perfect anything on the outside, or I'll do an outline for whatever is needed. Yeah, I really wasn't sure how to finish these. It just looks so empty. This is a little too watery. I should have done more paint. I only just started working with fabric medium too. And I find that I love it. I love the idea of fabric medium. Only because I work with shoes, and shoes, when you walk around with them, they bend. And it's my fear, you know, that I send someone a pair of shoes that just get ruined right away because of all the paint. And I'm sure that I'm not the only one who's encountered this. People who do paint these kind of shoes. Thinking I will do orange as an outline. And then little blue paw prints behind. Just a couple, not too many. But behind him. Because I didn't want it to look empty. Sorry about that. You know what I've stuck in my head? I have El Dorado, the movie Road to El Dorado. John Elton. I don't even know the name of the song. That was a funny movie. It's on Netflix right now. I just had it on while I was cleaning the other day. Yeah. So here comes out the perfectionist in me. To the rescue! Why did I put that so close to there? And I can't fix it. It's too late to fix it. Maybe next time I will learn and use pencil first. But could I do some like lines? No. No. We will just stick with what we got. A little more white paint. Thicken it up. So anyways, you know, I never finished what I was talking about, which is probably going to happen quite a bit. Fabric medium keeps your fabrics from creasing. It keeps it from wrinkling. It helps move the paint move with the fabric. So when I say that I worry about it, that will help. That's way too much paint. Well, it'll dry. So all I do is I take my little fabric medium and here it is, and you pour how much with the, it says one part of the fabric medium and two parts paint. So I always just kind of guesstimate. But I do like this. I got a Hobby Lobby, $6. It's kind of expensive to me. It was so cheap. But I do like it, and I can feel the difference in the paint. I can, for sure. I just hope that that translates to when someone's wearing the shoes. this into a recycling symbol instead, because he's got a little recycling symbol on his collar. I think I'm gonna put that here too. Just something extra. I don't think I would put white here. I don't think it's necessary. So, now, I think I will outline this. Let me show you my paint markers. I don't know how you pronounce that. Pasca. And I really love these. They're really, really great. And I use them a lot. It's so much so that I got a second set this Christmas. It was so sweet. My ma gave me a pair, not a pair, a set, another set for Christmas, because I use them so much. And, you know, moms believe in their kids, so they go, "Oh, honey, let me get you something dueling." My mom does not talk like that. Well, oh, that's in your head though, isn't it? I'm just trying to get a picture of a recycling symbol. I guess I could probably Google it. Recycling symbol. Here we go. Well, first I need to outline this, so I think I'll just outline this first. You know what though? Yeah, we'll just outline it first. Don't worry about anything else. Because I gotta tell ya, I'm all out of sorts trying to figure out having a camera on and painting. It's kind of nerve-wracking, to say the least. Okay, so I've got this outlined. My concern is this. So, I don't know if you can see this. I kind of scratched it away, but this paint, it will crack a bit. And I feel like if I just put a little bit of paint on there, that might keep that from cracking. But, do I want to chance it? When I scratched it like that, then the cracking kind of came off. I don't know if I really want to chance that though, so I think I won't. Put just a little smidge of paint on there. Just a smidge. Look at me using Q-tips. How professional. You know what? Oh well. Sometimes I use Q-tips. Q-tips can be used for quite a variety of reasons, can't they? Let's put Does it really need another paw print set? I don't think so. Really isn't much of a need. It's just a drop of the paint. Medium. It's kind of a couple drops, but it'll work on the same. And you know what's kind of amazing though? Paint medium is white, but it's right in there, doesn't it? It turns clear when it dries. I don't even need this much. I kind of want it to be a really dry coat. Because this is just a really thin coat of white. Just one coat of it. You know, I almost didn't do this. I'm like, you know what, Melissa? Just go for it. You paint those paw prints, freestyle it, and I'm like, you won't kick yourself. Here I am, painting over it, kicking myself. That's what happens when I freestyle it. I could never be a rapper. Rapper taking back his words. Or her. Sorry about that. Didn't know you were in frame. So you can still see this, but maybe the case, because you won't pay attention to it once the recycling mark is on it. You're not gonna see that. I think you could probably see it a little bit better on camera for some reason, but in person it doesn't look like it shows up that much. These are a little girl's shoes, so she's not gonna notice either. She really won't. And sometimes I just have to tell myself that. I just have to say, you know what? They're not gonna notice. They're not. Only you can see that. Let's see if this is dry. I'd say so. I'd say it's dry enough for a first coat of outline. So I'm gonna outline this in orange. Don't you love that? Sorry, this camera's wobbling. Rocky. My sister has a friend named Rocky. I think it's so cute. That's obviously your nickname. I wonder if you could guess what her real name is. What kind of nickname would it be from Rocky for a girl? Give you a guess. It'll be a cryptic hint. Welch's. Welch's grape juice. Welch's grape jam. I thought I would like this better than I do, because I was kind of going for like a... Yeah, that looks goofy, doesn't it? Because that's the only one that looks like that. And I think from far away, that will look silly. So I think I'll paint over that. But I could probably make... This has got to look professional. And to me, this doesn't look professional. I'm going to have to outline it in black for sure. But other than that, this still is not up to my standards. So, what we could do is some stripes, just like the other shoe had. Take a look and see how that looks. Why this takes me so long. Let's see. No, I think just all orange is gonna be the best way to go about this. Don't like all the white. I'm in my, what I like to call my basement, but really it's only a one step down from the rest of my house. And that's where the heater is. So it kicks on a lot. I don't know if that's really allowed to or not, though. I'd have to check the video after I'm done. Oh, I wonder if this would scratch off. I think just the orange is gonna look better. The reason I do this is because I just thought it would be nice to show some of the process behind my painting. You can find my work on my Pinterest, my Etsy, my Instagram, and my Facebook. I have outlets for all of those, and I thought, well, this would be fun too. See, now this could probably be outlined. Maybe I should do an outline of black first, and then of the worry about how thin I'm making my black outline. To the rescue. Look at that age. It's terrible. Don't mind me. I really like the outline. Sometimes, though, I have to hold my breath so that I can keep a steady hand while I outline. I like the outline, or I like using these markers because you can kind of correct your own work. See, like this? See? The orange is just gonna go inside of it, so that's okay if it's a little screwed up. And by the end, it'll look really cool. So I'm gonna call it a day. Now, this is not finished, but this is coming up on almost 30 minutes, and I'm gonna stop this video. I may continue on. I may continue on it and make another video, or I may just finish things up myself. I'll see. I've got to see how I can upload this video, and regardless of whether I do or don't, I will continue to make more videos, and I will be back with putting finishing touches on this. I also have a shoe. Another set of shoes that I have to finish. So follow back or come back and watch out for more videos, because I will be posting more. And I hope you enjoyed this.